Hello there, guys. Welcome back to another Gravity Falls video, where today we discuss what exactly is Bill Cipher. Using my understanding of science, I will deduce a scientific theory on what this dream demon really is. Remember, this is only a theory, but who knows, maybe it's right. Alex, the creator of Gravity Falls, has shown that he has at least some understanding of physics and science. Now, let me clarify this. In this video, we will be discussing what Bill Cipher is, not who Bill Cipher is. That is for a later vid. Now first off, if you do not know who Bill Cipher is, please watch the first season of Gravity Falls before you watching this video. You will just get confused by watching this episode. Bill Cipher is a mystical character in the animated series Gravity Falls and has a lot of subtle hints to him that you might get very confused by if you haven't seen the series. Alright, that being said, let's start off with the inspiration of Bill Cipher. Bill Cipher is obviously inspired by the symbol, the Eye of Providence. The symbol displays a pyramid with the Eye of Horus on the top of it. It refers to the all-seeing Eye of God and the ever-present watch of more powerful entities. In modern times, this symbol was adopted by multiple secret societies, most famously the Freemasons, and was even more recently given to the rumored secret society, the Illuminati, a society allegedly always watching the lifestyle of random citizens. The majority of Bill Cipher is made of this symbol, and probably refers to his always-watching lifestyle.
And you later.
But know this.
When darkness approaches, a day will come in the future when everything you care about will change. Until then, I'll be watching you. I'll be watching you.
Bill Cipher also draws some inspiration from Lovecraftian lore, like similar things in Gravity Falls. Like the cosmic beings described by Lovecraft, such as Cthulhu and Dagon, Bill Cipher is an ever-present threat, more powerful than humanity. Bill Cipher can be summoned, a trait shared by many Lovecraftian creatures, and Bill Cipher also seems to take pleasure in the manipulation of mortals, such as humans, similar to the Elder Things and once again Cthulhu. Bill Cipher is sort of a mix of both the modern paranoia of lack of privacy and the old horror literature of Lovecraft.
Name's Bill Cipher, and I take it you're some kind of living ventriloquist dummy? I'm just kidding, I know who you are, Gideon.
What are you? How do you know my name?
Oh, I know lots of things.
Lots of things.
I think I know a guy.
Now, this is where things get a little confusing. We will use science to determine what Bill Cipher is. In the series, Bill Cipher is described as a dream demon. He has the power to manipulate people's dreams as well as the physical environment. He also has the ability to control time and space. Bill Cipher also has such powers as telepathy and omnipotence, the ability to know all and be in many different places. These powers are actually achievable by science, believe it or not, therefore hinting at what he really is. Bill Cipher seems to come from another world called the Mindscape. The Mindscape appears to be an alternate dimension where memories and dreams are located. It seems to coexist with our world, but we are unable to observe it. Scientifically speaking, this would mean Bill Cipher is either an interdimensional being or an interuniversal being. It's hard to say which. An interdimensional being is a being or creature from another dimension other than our third dimension. An extra-universal being, or an inter-universal being, on the other hand, is a being that dwells outside our universe. This would technically allow this being to not have to abide by the laws of physics, therefore having the powers of a god. No scientific proof has been found of these such beings, but mathematically they are possible. It's hard to say if the Mindscape, in which Bill Cipher dwells in, is another dimension or another universe. More evidence leans to Bill Cipher being an interdimensional being, living in another dimension. Let me explain how dimensions work. Our universe is made of nanoparticles that are aligned in many different ways, giving us different dimensions. We currently live in the third dimension. We have nanoparticles aligned in length, width, and height. The second dimension only has nanoparticles aligned in height and length. The fourth dimension has height, length, width, and time. These theories of dimensions are calculations of Einstein. Now, bringing this back to the show, maybe Alex wants to incorporate these ideas inside the show. Gravity Falls has made a reference to Einstein's theories once before. It's not too far of a stretch to believe that Gravity Falls may include ideas of multiple dimensions in the future. So, with this information, I can come to the conclusion that Bill Cipher is a being from the fourth dimension, as he calls it, the mindscape. As said before, the fourth dimension is a dimension of time. Now, as we can see, Bill Cipher is greatly associated with time. Whenever he is summoned, he slows down and stops time. He has the power to slow down time and stop time. And on more than one occasion, he has pulled out a watch or a clock, the symbol of time itself. My theory is that Bill Cipher is actually a being dwelling in another dimension, most likely the fourth dimension, which he likes to call the mindscape, only transforming partially into our dimension every now and then. If the theory of Bill Cipher coming from another dimension, preferably the fourth dimension, were true, it would answer why he has such a strange triangular shape. In reality, Bill Cipher exists in between dimensions. Bill Cipher is both in our dimension and the fourth dimension, as speculated. If this were the case, Bill Cipher might have a similar effect a three-dimensional figure has on the second dimension. There is an effect called difference in dimensional perception. For example, if we 3D shapes entered the second dimension, we would appear like strange, unfamiliar beings, only appearing as two-dimensional forms of ourselves. In truth, we are most likely only seeing a tidbit of the real Bill Cipher. As the second dimension would perceive us differently, it is entirely possible that Bill Cipher's full form is different than the form we see of him in Gravity Falls in the third dimension. This would be due to the constraints and limitations that a dimension can display. We might be only perceiving a part of Bill Cipher. The rest of him cannot be perceived in our third dimension. This might answer why he has such a strange triangular shape. In his dimension, he isn't triangular at all, but something above your three-dimensional mind's comprehension. Our dimension simply limits our perception of him, giving us the triangular shape. This effect is actually referenced in sock opera, in how Dipper could not be perceived by the three-dimensional people when he is in the mindscape. He was limited by our dimensional perception. Again, all this is just a theory. Bill Cipher may or may not be from another dimension. This idea of Bill Cipher's appearance being limited by the constraints of our dimension would actually answer why and how he obtains his magical abilities. His abilities could just be completely normal things in his dimension, but due to the limitations of our dimensional perception, Bill Cipher's normal actions appear like magical abilities. Bill Cipher comes from a plane of existence higher than our own, therefore has power over our dimension. This would explain how he is able to create things such as this impossible space we can see here. If Bill Cipher is from another dimension, this would explain why he doesn't exist, as he tells Dipper. In my theory, he does not exist in our dimension, but in another, the mindscape. Only a part of him is seen due to the limitations of our dimensional perception. Now, what about Bill Cipher's quote?
Man, it has been so long since I've inhabited a body.
Yes, you heard that right. Bill Cipher just admitted that he wasn't always in the position of cosmic power he currently is in, suggesting he's had a body before. If Bill Cipher had a physical body, this would suggest he was once human. A human that ascended into another dimension, such as the fourth, which he calls the mindscape. If this were true, Bill Cipher might have a similar backstory to the futures in the movie Interstellar. Spoiler alert, in the film, future humans travel or ascend into another dimension, appearing like gods to the humans of our third dimension. Maybe Bill Cipher is no different. So to sum it all up, my scientific analysis brings me to the conclusion that Bill Cipher is an interdimensional being that once was a human and transcended into the fourth dimension by unknown means, which he calls the mindscape. After his transcendence into the mindscape, Bill Cipher acquired godlike powers and uses them currently inside Gravity Falls. He constantly fools, tricks, and takes pleasure from tricking the human mortals of this dimension. Now, who was Bill Cipher in life as a human? Now that is a theory for another day.